So, talking about important truths about excellence, the first thing I'll say is this, which is our starting point, is this. God is excellent. God is excellent. So, we talk about excellence, you must start with God. He is excellent. And we're going to look at quite some scriptures that show that. That is excellence we're talking about, it emanates from God. It's what God is. He wasn't going to compromise. From get-go, Daniel 1:8, we see how the Bible says that Daniel proposed in his heart that he will not defile himself with the portion of the king's meat, nor with the wine which he drank. Therefore requested of the prince of the eunuchs that he will not defile himself. So, his heart was set to do the right thing. He proposed in his heart. So like we said, it's a heart thing. Moral quality. Those are things we see about excellence. And we'll just spend some time, you know, looking at some important things about excellence. And then we'll also talk about how do I walk in excellence? How do I cultivate this excellent spirit? So, talking about important truths about excellence, the first thing I'll say is this, which is our starting point, is this. God is excellent. God is excellent. So, we talk about excellence, you must start with God. He is excellent. And we're going to look at quite some scriptures that show that. That is excellence we're talking about, it emanates from God. It's what God is. It's what God has. He's excellent. In Psalm 8, verse 1, the Bible says, O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth, who has set thy glory above the heavens. So we see there that God's name is spoken of as being excellent. Now, verse 9 of this same chapter, this same psalm, Psalm 8, verse 9, it says, O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth. So it's repeated again. His name is excellent. We know that a person's name describes him. You know, God was called Jehovah Jireh, the God who sees ahead and makes provision, because it showed his character. God was called El Shaddai, said, I'm the Almighty God. I'm the All-Sufficient One. Walk before me and be thou perfect. So, God's names depict God's character. And if his name is excellent, it's because he's excellent. In Job chapter 37. So, we're talking about important truths about excellence. And I said, number one, God is excellent. Job 37, verse 23. Touching the Almighty, we cannot find him out. He is excellent in power and in judgment and in plenty of justice. He will not afflict. So God is excellent in power. He is excellent in judgment. And he's excellent in plenty of justice. So we see there that excellence is spoken of relative to God. Psalm 36 and verse 7. It says, how excellent is thy loving kindness, O God. Therefore the children of men put their trust under the shadow of thy wings. So God's mercies are excellent. They stand out. His loving kindness stands out. It's excellent. Psalm 76, verse 4. It says, thou art more glorious and excellent than the mountains of prey. To get that in context, let's start from verse 1. In Judah is God known. His name is great in Israel. In Salem also is his tabernacle and his dwelling place in Zion. There break he the arrows of the bow, the shield, and the sword, and the battle. Thou art more glorious and excellent than the mountains of prey. The stout-hearted are spoiled. They have slept their sleep, and none of the men of might have found their hands. At thy rebuke, O God of Jacob, both the chariot and horse are cast into a dead sleep. Thou, even thou, art to be feared. And who may stand in thy sight when once thou art angry? Thou didst cause judgment to be heard from heaven, and the earth feared and was still. So you see here, he's speaking about him being more excellent than the mountains of prey. His character, excellence. In Psalm 148, the book of Psalms actually was Israel's prayer and song book. So there's a lot in it that extols God, that magnifies him, that talks about his attributes. Psalm 148 verse 13, it says, let them praise the name of the Lord, for his name alone is excellent. His glory is above the earth and heaven. He's an excellent God. Psalm 150 verse 2, praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him according to his excellent greatness. So whether you're talking about in power, you're talking about in loving kindness, you're talking about in judgment, you're talking about in plenty of justice, you're talking about even in splendor, God stands out. He excels. He's excellent. Isaiah chapter 12, in verse 5, it says, sing unto the Lord, for he hath done excellent things. He is known in all the earth. So God isn't just excellent in his attributes. He's also excellent in the things he does. He's excellent in the things he does. So it's an attribute. Isaiah chapter 12 verse 5 is an attribute he has. And he doesn't just have it. He displays it. He reveals it. It shows in his actions. Isaiah 28. Isaiah 28, in verse 29. The Bible says, this also cometh forth from the Lord of hosts, which is wonderful in counsel and excellent in walking. Now, so these are beginning to talk about his actions. Yes, he's an attribute of his. He stands out. He's excellent. He surpasses everything. He surpasses everyone. He does his things excellently too. So he's excellent in his attributes, talking about his character. He's also excellent in his actions. Well, you say all these scriptures are in the Old Testament. Do we have anything talking about God being excellent in the New? Certainly. In Hebrews chapter 1, from verse 1, the Bible says, God who at sundry times and in diverse manners spake in time past unto the fathers by the prophets, has in these last days spoken to us by his Son, whom he hath appointed heir of all things, by whom also he made the worlds, who being the brightness of his glory, the express image of his person, and upholding all things by the word of his power, when he had by himself purged our sins, sat down on the right hand of the majesty on high. Now verse 4, which is where I was going, he says, being made so much better than the angels, as he hath by inheritance obtained a more excellent name than they. Now, this is obviously talking about the Lord Jesus Christ. And he's talking about how he excels. He stands out. We can't compare him with an angel. You know, in the book of Hebrews, we see there talking about angels, talking about Aaron, you know, as a servant in his house, how Jesus excelled that. Talking about Melchizedek in the Old Testament, talking about the Levitical priesthood. So there was a lot of comparison between the old, the new, and between different things in the old, and how Jesus stood out. He stood out. Amen. He obtained a more excellent name. Now in Hebrews chapter 8, verse 6, talking about the new covenant that Jesus established in his blood, it says, but now hath he obtained a more excellent ministry, by how much also is the mediator of a better covenant, which was established upon better promises. So Jesus, in establishing the New Testament, also revealed this character about God. He's excellent. He's excellent. The old covenant was established in the blood of bulls and goats. The New Testament was established in the blood of the Son of God. And because Jesus is now the one that we're talking about, he stood out. Amen. His ministry stands out. So the point I'm making here is this: God is excellent. When you talk about excellence, it emanates from God. Everything about God speaks of excellence. He does everything with excellence. He is excellent. In creation, we see his excellence, the precision, the attention to detail, the specificity. Why did God first make light? Why was there the sun before there were the plants? Why were there the plants before there were the animals? Why were there the animals before there was man? You know, God thought it through.